Waheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Waheguru Ji Ki Fateh. Now we come on to this money, this beautiful jewel of the Guru, Tan Pai Mani Singh Ji, Brahm Gyani Mahapurush, Jinnane Tan Man Tan Karke did the seva of Guru Sahib for a total of 77 years. It is well known that Pai Mani Singh Ji was a scribe for Guru Gobind Singh Sahib Ji Maharaj. But Pai Mani Singh didn't just write Gurbani, they were the embodiment of Gurbani, showing us how to live in the Guru's way, literally showing the meanings of Shabads like Tan Man Kaat Kaat Sab Arpi Vich Agni Aap Jalai. Their Shahidi is one of the greatest, not just in our Itihas, but in the history of the whole world. You'll never find a story of Gurbani like this. One jeeb, one tongue cannot say the praise of Tan Pai Mani Singh Ji, who even when getting cut limb by limb at the ripe age of 90 years old, even then they didn't have even one bit of doubt, nor did they question ki, Maharaj, I've done so much seva, why am I getting this pain? They remained calm in the love of Guru Sahib, shocking even the executioner who was witnessing this miracle. If we get a cut on our body, we cry out, we get a plaster put on and we get it mended. But this great Gursikh got cut limb by limb, band band katya gaya, without even making a single sound other than the blessed words of Sri Sukhmani Sahib. But Sangaji, if we look into the family of Tan Pai Mani Singh Ji, even just look at the history from Pai Sahib's grandfather to their grandson, then actually we won't be surprised that Pai Mani Singh Ji was shaheed in such a calm manner. Pai Mani Singh Ji's family define the word shahidi and kurbani for Guru Sahib. Sangaji, just try to comprehend this. All together, 29 direct members of Pai Mani Singh Ji's family were shaheed. They were probably the most famous family in Sikh Itihas, and we may have heard of some of the family members, individual shahidi sakhiya, but today we will see how they all link to Pai Mani Singh Ji. Sacrifice in the family started many years before Pai Mani Singh Ji. In fact, take your minds back to the times of Sri Guru Har Gobind Sahib Ji Maharaj and the Battle of Amritsar. When Murtaza Khan attacked Guru Sahib, the very same person who was responsible for arresting Guru Arjan Dev Sahib Ji Maharaj and taking them to Chandu. So basically, Murtaza Khan played a direct role in the Shahidi of Sri Guru Arjan Dev Sahib Ji Maharaj. Itihas states that Pai Balu Ram was the one who killed Murtaza Khan using his barsha, his spear. This great warrior, Pai Balu Ram, was the grandfather of Pai Mani Singh Ji and contributed to Maharaj's victory in this battle and was also Shaheed fighting for Guru Sahib Ji. Pai Balu Ji's son, Mai Das Ji, was the father of Pai Mani Singh Ji, and they would join in the seva of Guru Har Gobind Sahib Ji Maharaj and Guru Har Rai Sahib Ji Maharaj, and was the one who brought Pai Mani Singh Ji into the company of the Guru. Mai Das had 12 sons, including Pai Mani Singh Ji. Just think for 1 second, Sangat Ji, how great are the parents of Pai Mani Singh Ji. Out of their 12 sons, 11 were shaheed for the Guru. Bas ik si jera shaheed nahi hoya, Amar Chand is said to have passed away in his infancy. Baki sare shaheed. The eldest son was Pai Jetha Ji, who was shaheed in battle, but this time fighting for Sri Guru Gobind Singh Ji Maharaj in their first battle, Pangani Di Jang. The second eldest son was Pai Dayal Das Ji, the same Pai Dayala Ji that we remember every day in our Ardas when bowing down to the Shaheeds. The same Pai Dayala Ji who was Shaheed alongside Pai Mati Das Ji and Pai Sati Das Ji in an attempt to shock and scare Guru Tegh Bahadur Sahib Ji Maharaj, who was locked in a cage in public during the live executions. In Delhi Chandni Chowk, many had gathered to have darshan of Guru Sahib and these three Gursikhs. Firstly, Pai Dayala Ji, the brother of Pai Mani Singh Ji, was approached by the Qazi. He said, ki, convert to Islam, you will live in peace with all joy and pleasures that life can provide. Hearing this, Pai Dayala Ji explained that for a Gursikh, the most happy and blessed time is of Shahidi, and ordered the Qazi to stop wasting his breath. The Qazi asked Pai Dayala Ji if he had any last wish. And Tan Guru Ka Pyara Pai Dayala Ji, the elder brother of Pai Mani Singh Ji, said he had only one last request. Ke jado mainu shaheed karauna, when you execute me, face me in the direction of my Guru, Sri Guru Tegh Bahadur Sahib Ji. Look at the prem these beloved Gursikhs had for Guru Sahib. Even till the last breath, their heart yearned for Guru Ji. Pai Dayala Ji was then placed in a large cauldron of water. He stood there with folded hands and did an ardas. Guru Arjan Dev Sahib Ji Maharaj, You endured the boiling cauldron of Chandul. Now please be hazard with me to allow me to endure Aurangzeb's boiling cauldron. Bhai Dayalaji started Sri Sukhmani Sahib the Pard, and as the wood burned and the water boiled, so did the body of Bhai Dayalaji. Still, Bhai Dayalaji remained fixated on the charan of Guru Tegh Bahadur Sahib Ji Maharaj till their last breath. Then Bhai Mati Das Ji was shaheed by being sawn in half from head to toe. And Bhai Sati Das Ji, the brother of Bhai Mati Das Ji, was also shaheed by being wrapped in cotton and set alight. So in the same way, the rest of Bhai Mani Singh's brothers were shaheed. Three more of his brothers died fighting for Guru Gobind Singh Sahib Ji Maharaj in battle. Bhai Hathi Chand was shaheed during the Battle of Pangani and fought so bravely that he is mentioned in Guru Gobind Singh Ji's Bani, Sri Dasam Guru Granth Sahib Ji. Bhai Sohan Chand was shaheed in the Battle of Nadaun. Bhai Lerna Singh was also shaheed fighting for Guru Gobind Singh Ji. And some of the other brothers were shaheed after Maharaj's time. So Bhai Mani Singh Ji watched as one by one his brothers sacrificed their all for the Guru. Now on to Bhai Mani Singh Ji's 10 sons, out of which 7 were shaheed. 2 of Bhai Mani Singh Ji's sons, his eldest son, Bhai Chitra Singh, one of the younger sons, Bhai Gurbakh Singh, and his wife, Mata Sito, also known as Basant Kaur, were shaheed alongside Bhai Mani Singh Ji, as we will hear in a later episode. The second eldest son, Bhai Bachitra Singh, is the same Bachitra Singh who single-handedly fought off the intoxicated elephant in the Battle of Anandapur using the Nagani Barsha. Bhai Bachitra Singh, filled with so much biras and power, fired the spear which smashed through 7 layers of iron into the head of the Hathi, causing it to run back, destroying the enemy forces as they retreated. We normally hear these Sakya, but we don't make the connections between them. This great Surma, Bhai Bachitra Singh, was the second eldest son of Bhai Mani Singh Ji and was also shaheed in battle. The third son was Bhai Udaya Singh, who was the chief, the general of Guru Gobind Singh Ji's forces. And in the Battle of Anandpur Sahib, just as Maharaj blessed Bhai Bachitra Singh to challenge the Hathi, Maharaj blessed Bhai Udaya Singh to challenge Kesari Chand, the head of the enemy forces. Bhai Udaya Singh ik vaar de naal decapitated Kesari Chand and brought his head back to Guru Sahib and pierced on a spear and placed it in the charan of Guru Gobind Singh Sahib Ji Maharaj, marking their victory. With the death of their commander-in-chief, the hill forces retreated in fear, and Bhai Udaya Singh was declared the hero of that jung. Later on, when Guru Gobind Singh Sahib Ji and the Sangat left Sri Anandpur Sahib, it was Bhai Udaya Singh who fought bravely holding back the enemy forces so that Guru Sahib and the Sangat could cross the Sarsa Nadi. First, Baba Ajit Singh Ji was holding back the forces, and Bhai Udaya Singh Ji asked permission to go back and help Baba Ajit Singh Ji. Guru Sahib Ji gave him his blessings as they knew he was never to return. Bhai Udaya Singh took over command and requested Baba Ajit Singh Ji to go back and join Guru Sahib. And that Atharathi Surma, 10 lakh naal mukabla kita, 4.5 ghante layi, for 4.5 hours fought and held back the forces. His arrows ran out, he fought with his sword, with his talwar, till eventually, being completely surrounded, he was wounded countless times and he fell to the ground and breathed his last. Later on in that month of Poh, Bhai Dan Singh Ji, Bhai Mani Singh Ji's brother, along with 3 of Bhai Mani Singh Ji's sons, Bhai Anak Singh, Bhai Ajab Singh, and Bhai Ajab Singh, were also shaheed fighting over 1 million forces in the Battle of Chamkaur Sahib. How blessed were they? They were shaheed with Sri Guru Gobind Singh Sahib Ji Maharaj giving their blessed nadar as one by one they left the fort of Chamkaur Sahib to face the forces. Also Sangat Ji, although not a direct blood relation, but Bhai Mani Singh Ji's father-in-law was Bhai Lakhi Shah, who was the same Gursikh who, when Sri Guru Tegh Bahadur Sahib Ji Maharaj was shaheed in Chandni Chowk, security was placed around Maharaj and it was announced that no one could come near the body. Coming up with a cunning plan, Bhai Lakhi Shah, gathering hundreds of bulls and carts filled with cotton, charged at the site, causing confusion and dispersing the guards. The body of Sri Guru Tegh Bahadur Sahib Ji Maharaj was placed into one of the carts, and then, since all the forces were searching for the body of Maharaj, it wasn't possible to do the cremation outside. Then Bhai Lakhi Shah, just to peacefully complete the final rites and the cremation of Sri Guru Tegh Bahadur Sahib Ji Maharaj, they brought Maharaj into his own home, which he prepared to sacrifice. Without removing any possessions, he placed large quantities of sandalwood, and then the cremation began inside his house. His possessions and expensive house burned away, But for him, at least as a Sikh of the Guru, he was able to complete the cremation with true respect for Maharaj Sahib. Such sacrifice of Bhai Lakhi Shah, the father-in-law of Bhai Mani Singh Ji. Nowadays, Gurdwara Rakabganj Sahib is built on the exact location where Lakhi Shah burnt his house to do the sanskar of Guru Tegh Bahadur Sahib Ji. Even Bhai Mani Singh Ji's grandsons were shaheed, mostly in battle after the times of the Gurus, some alongside Baba Banda Singh Bahadur in battles such as the Jung of Chappar Chiri, Sadaura and Sirhand. Our history is limitless, and we are just going to be looking at the shaheedi of Bhai Mani Singh Ji in detail. But truly, their whole family were amazing, and each of these shaheeds have a katha, a history of their own. That's how large their family contribution is towards Guru Sahib Sikhi. Sangha Ji, altogether, 29 members of Bhai Mani Singh Ji's direct family were shaheed. If you look at other relatives and close associates of Bhai Mani Singh Ji, that number easily increases to 60 plus. That sacrificed their all for Guru Sahib Ji. Next week, we will look into the jeevan and life of Tan Tan Bhai Mani Singh Ji themselves. Lekha katana shuti hai, kin kin phoolan haar, baksan haar, baks lai nanak paar utar, Vaheguru Ji ka khalsa, Vaheguru Ji ki fateh.
Please like, comment, subscribe and share this video to spread the message of Sikhi. Make your dasvand safala and donate so we can create more content like this. The link is in the description below.